Let me just take an example. We are talking about a world where three different kinds of fruits are available: mango, oranges, and mango, orange, and let us say apple. Does not matter, it is just for illustration, it does not matter what fruits you choose. Okay, three. Let us say in the first bundle you have only mango, in the second bundle you have only one orange, and in the third bundle you have only one apple. Let me also show you how you will write it mathematically. 1, 0, 0, let us say first number gives you the first, it gives you number of mangoes, second gives you number of oranges, third gives you number of apple. So, in the second you will have 0, 1, 0, and in the third you will have 0, 0, 1, means 0 mango, 0 orange and 1 apple. Now, let us say there is a person who likes the bundle 1 more than bundle 2. So, 1 mango is preferred over 1 orange, and 1 orange is preferred over 1 apple. And how about if 1 apple is preferred over 1 mango? So, what is happening? Mango for you is better than orange, orange is better than apple, but apple is better than mango. It happens to us that we say that if tea and coffee is there, I will take tea. If coffee and coke is there, I will take coffee, but coke and tea is there, then I will take coke. We exhibit this kind of choice, but if we exhibit this kind of choice, then one thing that you can say colloquially about this person, that his choices are inconsistent. And we cannot talk, I am not saying this consumer theory does not say that you cannot have this kind of preference, this kind of liking. It is not saying, only thing that it is saying that if you have this kind of liking, we cannot use the theory that we are going to learn further to describe your choices, because there is a randomness in your inconsistency in the way you are making choices. So, when we want to talk about how a person is making choice, how a person is choosing, then there should be some consistency in the way he functions, in the way he makes choices. So, I am not excluding, I am not saying that you cannot have choices of this kind, but we would not be able to talk about. So, we are putting certain restrictions, certain in the axiom forms, in the building block form. And the first axiom that I want to talk about is completeness. And what does completeness mean? Have you ever heard this term completeness? What does it mean?
That you should not have your preferences in cyclic order.
No, it does not say that.
It should be with the...
It does not say that. It has nothing to do with the earlier example I gave you. I will come back to that example in some other property or in some other axiom, but not for this axiom or for this property. Here it is very simple. Let me say again, let me say start with two bundles. X and Y are any two bundles in the conjunction set. Fine. X and Y are any two bundles in the conjunction set. You should be able to say one of these three things about X and Y. Either you should say able to say that you prefer, you like, you prefer X to, you prefer X to Y, or you should be, or you should be able to say you prefer Y to X. And third, or you should be able to say that you are indifferent about X and Y. One of these three things you should be able to say. Fine. And these things can be rewritten in a different form also. You can also say that X is at least as preferred as Y, or Y is at least as preferred as X, and third, X and Y, you are indifferent among X and Y. Here again you have 3, but here 3 are mutually exclusive. If 1 is true, you cannot have second. If second is true, you cannot have first and third. If third is true, you cannot have first and second. But here these are basically saying the same thing as the earlier one, but here these are not mutually exclusive. Let us say if you like X and Y exactly the same, then all 3 would be true. X is at least as preferred as Y, Y is at least as preferred as X, and you are indifferent between X and Y. Let me also use a notation to describe it. This is written as X is, you prefer X to Y, of course I am talking about you. This is not, this symbol is not same as this. This is greater than, this is preferred to. So, this symbol means is preferred to, and this is Y is preferred to X, and this is you are indifferent, this is sign that says indifference, it is like this. And here what we say, just like here we, it looks like similar to greater than, here the symbol would look similar to greater than and equal to. What it says, we are combining this and this one and this one and bringing it here. What it says, when X is at least as preferred to Y, as preferred as Y, either 1 is true or 3 is true. So, we are combining the symbol. Similarly, here Y is at least as preferred to X, and here X and Y. So, in other word, let me just describe what does it mean, that basically any, you are able to conceive different bundles in your mind, and all these conjunction bundles are in your conjunction set. When you pick any 2 bundles from this set, you should be able to compare them. You should be able to say that I like one over the other, okay? Or you are indifferent between these 2. Let me describe a situation just to clarify this concept. Sometime it happens, you are you are at your home and your mother asks you that would you take tea or coffee, and you are confused, you are not able to say. Does it exhibit completeness? By the way, these are property, we are talking about a choice of a person. So, I can say we are talking about preferences of a person. We are describing a preferences of a person. So, the question can be that, do you think your preferences are complete when you are confused between 2 different bundles? Here bundle is just, you can say, when someone is asking you coffee and tea, imagine that you are in a 2 good world and you have to choose between a bundle made of coffee and tea. If you prefer tea, then it is 1 tea, 0 coffee. You can always translate the problem in the mathematical term. Okay. So, do you think it is complete or it is not complete? Let me tell you, no, your preferences in this case are not complete, because you are not able to compare these 2, you are confused. These are 2 different things. When you are confused, you are not able to compare, but when you compare in your mind and you say, I do not care, I do not mind tea or coffee, it means you are, you know, you are indifferent between the two. So, that is not a state of confusion. Confusion is that you are not able to figure out, that situation is excluded. That situation is excluded. Fine? Is it clear? Completeness is clear to you? Okay. Now, let us talk about second axiom, and that sounds little, you know, let me warn you, it sounds, it is bit weird, but it is more of a mathematical requirement. Reflexivity. Reflexivity, what it says that you have a bundle, and when you compare this bundle with the same bundle, then you should be able to say that I prefer the first bundle at least as much as the second, the original bundle. So, when you have X, a bundle in the conjunction set capital X, this reflexivity property says that X is at least as preferred as X. And it sounds little funny that what is the need to talk about it, you know, it is okay. There is a one condition, when one situation where you should not talk about it. Remember, if some of you must have done mathematics, so you know this set X, or let me denote it using A, 1, 2, 3, this is a set A, and this is a set 1, comma, 2, comma, 3, comma, 1. By set theory definition, A and B are the same set. The only difference between A and B, and that, you know, you A and B are equal, that one is mentioned here twice. So, the reflexivity is for this kind of scenario. What if you pick this bundle and this bundle? Okay? They are the same bundle, but they are mentioned twice. So, even in this scenario, you should be able to compare them, able to compare them. That is what it is saying. So, it is more of a mathematical requirement than in economic in nature. Third property that I want to talk about is transitivity. And this is bit more problematic. First and second are okay, that you should be able to compare. Okay? That is what first and second are talking about. Transitivity, on the other hand, is talking about that not only you should be able to compare, you should be able to compare them in consistent fashion. So, what it says, let us take now three bundle x comma y comma z in X. Okay? If you say X is at least as preferred as Y, Y is at least as preferred as Z, then it implies that X is at least as preferred as Z. And remember the earlier example I gave you, mango, orange and apple. There this property is violated. Many times this property is not, you know, this property is violated in our real life. But when we are doing such thing, probably we are not thinking enough, we are, you know, or probably we are not thinking enough, and or we have inconsistent preference. It would be difficult for to make prediction about this scenario. Okay? Let me also say, is this clear? What it means is, let us just say here on these two axes, x1, x2, let us take 3, here is x, y and z. You are able to compare any two bundle you are picking, x and y. By first property, you should be able to compare them. And let us say you say X you prefer over Y, and then you pick another two bundles Z and Y, and you figure out that Y is at least as good as Z, then you should be able to say X is at least as good as Z. Fine? Now, let me say, you may feel that what I am saying is excluding various realistic scenarios. Let me talk about a very realistic scenario. Again, coming back to that example, mango, orange, apple. I am talking about it because you may feel that by using this, making this assumption, we are excluding various realistic scenarios. But those realistic scenarios are really bad. if you can look at it from this, using this example. Let us say that you have this kind of preference, that you prefer mango over orange, orange over apple, and apple over mango. And let us say in the monetary term that you are willing to, you know, let us say if I move you from orange to mango, you will pay me at least 1 rupees, okay, because you like mango more. So, of course, you are willing to pay more for mango, even though the price in the market is lower. That is immaterial right here. I am talking about your likings. So, let us say you have an orange and I have a mango. So, what we can do, and you are willing to pay at least 1 rupee, probably more than 1 rupee for getting this mango, exchanging this. So, what I can say, that I will give you mango, you give me orange and 1 rupee. So, now let us say I start with, there are 2 person, the person 1 has a mango and 1 apple, and person 2 has orange. And this is person 2's choice. So, now after this, what I have is 1 orange, 1 apple plus 1 rupee. And this person has now mango. And here, now let us look at it. Between mango and apple, this person prefers apple, and he is willing to give up at least 1 rupee when we exchange this apple with his mango. So, now I give him an apple and take his mango. So, what do I have now? 1 orange, 1 mango and 2 rupees. And what does this person has now? Apple. Fine. Now, we continue with this. We say, okay, between apple and orange, this person prefers orange. Okay? I say, okay, I will give you orange, that is originally his orange, and here he has minus 1 rupee, minus 2 rupee. Now, I will give you orange, and happily he will give me the apple along with 1 rupee. So, what I will have now, after I give up my orange and take apple from him, I will have 1 mango, 1 apple plus 3 rupees, and what this person will have? Orange that he has earlier, minus 3 rupees. So, each step, on each step, if he moved from here to here, here to here, here to here, all these transactions were beneficial to him. But we added up all the transaction, he is having a net loss of 3 rupees. So, why? Because he has inconsistent, or in technical term, intransitive preferences. Fine. So, that is why we assume that a person has transitive preference, if we want to talk about that person in consistent manner.